In this video, we're going to be going over block elements. The first thing you'll want to do is go into your GeneratePress dashboard and make sure that the Elements module is activated. Once it's activated, go into the Elements area. You'll see I've already pre-created some elements that we'll go over today. But first, let's just add a new element so we can get an idea of what we're working with. So we'll click the Add New Element button, and here we can choose the element type. So in this video, we're doing block elements, so we'll choose the block type and click Create. So as you can see here, this actually opens up the WordPress block editor. This is really cool because it allows us to visually create our content and then use the overall power of the Elements module to hook that content into various places throughout our website. So if you've worked with elements before, you've likely added a hook element. What's cool here is that these block elements work as hook elements and also other various kind of elements, which I'll show you right now. So let's just skip the actual editor and go down to the settings first. So you'll see we have a block type with the default block type being a hook. So this hook, it allows us to create whatever kind of content we want, whether it be a call to action, it could be a page hero, it can be an author box, and then we can hook that content in throughout our website using GeneratePress and GP Premium hooks, which you can choose from here. You can also use custom hooks, which are helpful if you're using another plugin or you've added your own hooks inside of a child theme. You can also do site headers, site footers, right sidebars, and left sidebars. So this is only the start. We're planning to add more to these, but for the ones we've already added here, this will actually replace the default theme site header or whatever it is with what you create using the WordPress block editor. So if your standard GeneratePress site header isn't offering you the kind of customizability that you need, you can come in here and you can build your own site header and then you can replace it in the theme with what you've built. What's also cool is we have display rules. So again, if you've used elements before, you've used these, but if you haven't, these let you choose where this element shows up. So you can do the entire site, the front page, the blog, all singular, and so on and so forth. You can do individual posts, individual pages. If you have custom post types, those will show up in here as well. So you can really choose where you display whatever you're creating here. This means you can add conditional site headers, conditional sidebars, all this really cool stuff without needing another plugin to do it for you. You can also exclude it. So say you choose entire site from the location, you can say, I want the entire site except for the front page or except for the about page. And you can also do it for users. So for logged in users, logged out users. So say you have a sidebar you only want to show to people who are logged in. You can do that here. When we change these, say right sidebar, left sidebar, it actually changes the editor to try and give you an accurate representation of what that's going to look like on the front end. So that's the overall settings. And then for the actual block editor up here, I'm not going to go too in depth on creating things because there's an infinite amount of things you can do, and that's probably for another video. But I do want to note that if you're using a third-party block plugin, it may not work in here yet. That's because when these third-party block plugins go to create their CSS, their styling, they search the WordPress content and they go, do we have our block? Yes, we do. Here's our settings, and they create the CSS. Now, this isn't going to be added to the content. This is going to be added to the sidebar or the header or some hook throughout the theme. So these third-party plugins aren't aware of that, and they may not style properly. As time goes on, we hope to add more compatibility for that if these plugins allow us to do that in a clean way. But for now, you can use the core WordPress blocks, and you can also use our very own block plugin, Generate Blocks. We created this with GeneratePress in mind, and you can build pretty much whatever you want using Generate Blocks, and it's compatible with GP Premium and block elements. So let's go into a couple of these pre-created block elements that I've already built, and we'll kind of see what we can do. So the first one is a page hero. So let's click on that and see what we have. So you can see I've given it a title, and I've created this really nice page hero using generate blocks. So we have the container, and this isn't a video for generate blocks, but it's a free plugin, free to download, free to install, and it's super powerful. You can create pretty much anything you want, as you can see here. So I've created this really nice hero, and if we go down here, we'll see it's just a hook type, and I've hooked it in to after the header. So now all we have to do is give it a location. So let's say we want it on our about page, because that's the page I have up and ready to look at. So let's hit the update button and go check out the about page. So you can see here we have a very basic generate press site. So let's go ahead and refresh and see what happens. So now you can see this awesome page hero we've created visually shows up on our page that we've specified. Now before, you could do this using regular hook elements or even the header element. The only problem there was is you had to kind of know HTML and CSS to build this. Now that's not an issue. You can build it visually and hook it in. So what else do we have? Let's go check it out. We have a notice. So this is just a basic notice I've created using generate blocks again. It's a hook type and it's hooked into before the content. So again, let's just give it a location. Hit update and let's go check it out. And there it is. So you can hook this into the entire site, to every single page, to every single post. It really offers great flexibility and a lot of power into building your websites. On to the next one here. We have a call to action. So let's see what this does. This is just a super basic call to action. It has a title, it has a button. It's hooked into before the footer. So you can change these to whatever you want. After footer widgets, before the footer, it can overwrite your default site footer. You have ultimate control. So again, let's go in here, add it to the about page and see what it looks like. So if it's gonna be before the footer, it'll be down here. And there you go. We have our call to action. And we can add this throughout the site, throughout categories, whatever we want. Let's keep going. Right sidebar. Now these are really cool because what they will do is actually replace your existing sidebar with what we create in here. So before we would rely on the classic WordPress widget system. It worked really well. And of course in GeneratePress, you could choose your overall padding and your background colors for your widgets. But what you couldn't do is control those individually. So here you can see we have a green background, a white background, a gray blue background. We have buttons. So these are all created using generate blocks. And then what we can do is set this to our right sidebar. Now this will only work if the page we're working on has a right sidebar right now, because all it does is remove what you have in your right sidebar and then hook it into the right sidebar area. Now, if you want to keep your existing right sidebar widgets, we would just hook this into the inside right sidebar hook. But in this case, we want to replace it completely. So I've set it to right sidebar. Let's go and add it to our page and see what that does. So you can see here, we have some standard widgets. So let's give it a refresh. And now it's using this really nice sidebar that we've built and that we have full control over. So we can do the same with the left sidebar. And like I said, we don't need to replace the entire sidebar. We could just change this to a hook and we could just set it to inside a sidebar. So if we go down here, you'll see, here I'll give the search. We have before right sidebar content, after right sidebar content. So you don't have to replace it. In this case, we want to. So what else do we got? One more, site footer. So right now, using GeneratePress, you have the options to use footer widgets. You can set what width they are. You can set background colors, background images, all that kind of stuff. What you can't do is have full control over each individual widget. Using GeneratePress and the editor, we can control exactly what we want this to look like, which gives us ultimate power in creating pretty much whatever we want here. So you can see, I just have, this is just a GeneratePress container. I have a grid inside of it with more grid items, more containers, and I've added headlines and text and some social icon buttons. So we can go down here, set it to our site footer, go to our page and update. So right now we just have this really plain site footer. And if we did have footer widgets, those would show up here as well, and they would be replaced when I refresh. And now we have this really nice footer that we created from scratch. So as time goes on, we're really going to try and make it so you can create everything in your website using blocks. We're really excited about it. It's already really powerful, and we hope you like it. Thank you for watching.